It was the year 2002 when Mr. Menon was named Businessman of the Year. The owner of 5 national and international companies, he found himself suddenly catapulted into the public eye. Everybody wanted to know everything about him, his life, his struggles, his family, of which only I remain. One must leave work at the workplace, he used to say at interviews. It would have been far more effective if he had practiced it himself. Well, it wasn't that he had never tried, but somewhere, something went wrong, very wrong. June 14th, 2002, graduation day. As I reminisce, visions flash into my head. His missing the day, the explicit demand that I had made, which was never fulfilled, at least so I had thought. The sponsoring of a fancy car, which in my former opinion was nothing more than pocket change for my father. Although it may sound appalling to you at present, it was mundane for me. Probably having everything on a silver platter since childhood had something to do with it. And what did I get instead? A Bible? A book? It was just a book. Nothing more. With what seemed to be his negligence due to his time-consuming occupation, I had one last person to turn to. If I ever had to complain about my father, it was to her. If I ever had to moan about my life, it was to her. She knew everything about me. A mere look at my face would reveal my mind to her. She had told me to stop living in the moment and start taking life a little more seriously. Although my peer, she was infinitely wiser. When I was perturbed about my father, she told me to take time and understand the man. But I. My insolence, my demanding approach, rash decisions taken by the adolescent mind resulted in nothing but catastrophe. Ego. It's not entirely sinful, but it must be exercised with caution. This damned three-letter word is the root cause of my reluctance to perceive beyond the apparent. My obstinacy not to own up to my faults. The thoughts of redemption were right there in my head, but somehow they didn't help me in any way. They just clogged my mind, deprived me of clear thought, and at length made me succumb to stronger thoughts that said, was time for me to go. To go far, far away. Life goes on, one thing led to another, and then after many years, I would like to call myself settled. But after a while, you realize, time flies. In its due course, it brings darkness and light. The best thing that you can do is take whatever comes to you. And so I did. I would like to believe that my father was largely instrumental in affecting this change in my outlook towards life. My father? What? How? When? I was speechless. Stepping out of the world I had created for myself in the past many years, I came back like the prodigal son. But it was too late.
No.
He has many names. Some call him God, Almighty, the Supreme Being, the Alpha and the Omega. But it doesn't matter what one calls him, as long as one knows the greatness of him. He is the one who gives. He gives us life, even though that life is unpredictable. So give it all you have got while you have it. Of course, the one who gave me everything was my Father, the face of God on earth.